Initiating moisture.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Moisties. Unfortunately, Todd Howard wasn't able to host this year, so I'm doing it instead. It's me, Charlie. Today we're looking at the five best films of 2019. Let's kick this shit off at number five, which was Cutthroat. It was an extremely difficult time with the Wet Council deciding who earned the number five spot between Alita Battle Angel and Knives Out. And ultimately, I believe the Knights of the Wet Table have decided it should be Alita Battle Angel. The movie was such a fucking surprise and just criminally underrated. It's a shame, but it truly was just a treat to see on the big screen. An absolutely visually fantastic movie with some great action and choreography during their fight scenes that is just stunning to look at. And it flawlessly translated the anime style and manga of Alita Battle Angel to the big screen in a big budget over the top way, and made it appealing to people who even hate anime. Like, even if you don't like anime, Alita Battle Angel still fucking absolutely pounds ass. Just as an action movie alone, if nothing else. The only thing that I absolutely see people getting turned off by is the big eyes. But even then, once you get into the movie, it just becomes part of the character, and I don't think it's all that jarring and a detriment to it. Alita Battle Angel was the biggest surprise that I encountered in the theaters in 2019, because I expected nothing from it, but was blown away. Moving on to number four, it's another action movie, John Wick Chapter 3. I think most people saw this coming. John Wick Chapter 3 is just so incredibly strong. I didn't care as much for Chapter 2 of John Wick as I did the first one, but Chapter 3 blew both of them out of the water, in my opinion. I think Chapter 3 was the best of the series. It had some just absolutely nuts-to-butts action that was super fucking great. Keanu Reeves playing the stoic but menacing boogeyman. It just never gets old watching the Baba Yaga play in God mode here. The kills in the movie are creative. They're not just standard, you know, point-and-shoot, dead-man-type kills. Throwing fucking axes, killing men with pencils, using horses to kick people's skulls in half, riding motorcycles. I was half expecting John Wick to come in like fucking Tarzan on a rope and like teabag someone to death or something. It was just hardcore and just a joy. And Halle Berry played very well in this movie. Her dogs, in the scenes they were in, that shit was pretty goddamn cool as well. She even stole the show from John Wick during those scenes, which is hard to do. Just a really just thrilling, great action movie. And it's just so incredibly fun, and I can't recommend it enough. Moving on to number three, it's not an action movie, Marriage Story. Now, I know in the Hollywood Awards and shit, there's always that controversy, do Netflix movies count? Well, here at the Moisties, you bet your fucking ass they count. Marriage Story is a fantastic film, and this really real look into a messy divorce. Jackson wouldn't shut the fuck up about how good the movie was, but I didn't expect it to be this good. I came in thinking, okay, it'll be great acting, yeah, it's a given, I'm expecting that. But I didn't think the story and the characters would rope me in the way they did. At times you're rooting for the husband to be the one that comes out on top, at times the wife, at times you're mad at the wife, and other times you're mad at the husband. It keeps the viewer deciding who they think was in the right, but either way, you're feeling sad for what they're going through. Both characters are super well written. Their situation is very tough to look at, especially if you have come from an environment where something like that may have gone down, or you know someone that has. It goes without saying, divorces aren't the prettiest thing in the world, and this movie really shows it in its realest, most blinding light. It was a really, really good movie. And if you like acting and drama, I don't think there was one that did it better than Marriage Story this year. I swear to God, at times I felt like these were my parents divorcing and then I was the one caught in the middle just watching this movie. I was like, fuck, kind of want to go with Adam Driver, but damn it, Scarlett Johansson, she's making great points. I don't know, this movie just really has an emotional pull, gets you invested, and it's just everything it did really well. Moving on to number two, Joker. Joker, the most controversial movie human beings have ever even thought of. The most controversial thing that the world has ever seen. Joker, great film. An incredible performance from Joaquin Phoenix. The movie from top to bottom is just a great, dark, gritty film. It's not this over-the-top, hyper-violent movie where you have fucking tits and blood and guts flying all over the place. Fucking colons getting ripped out of assholes. It's nothing like that. It's a very deep look into the mind of an outcast, a psychopath, a lunatic. And it really captures that feeling and shows you just how dark all of those things are, getting to that point. And it makes the viewer sit back, take it in, and never let off the throttle. The movie is just really impressively done from start to finish, and it never really feels like it's trying too hard, you know? It never really goes so deep, like we live in a society type shit. And with the Joker's reputation on the internet, you know, the whole I'm the Joker baby, why so serious, all that just kind of becoming embarrassing and synonymous with the Joker's character and presence online, this movie never feels like it's just crazy for the sake of crazy. Like, oh, I'm so wild, I'm gonna pee my pants just to show you that I don't care about the system and I don't give a shit. It is just really well done. It shows you crazy without it ever being, you know, weird or out of place. It all fits the narrative, and the acting from Joaquin Phoenix really sells the entire narrative of the movie. And it's just a really great movie from no matter how you look at it. It is well shot, it's well made, and it's really engaging. Moving on to number one, Parasite. Parasite is a foreign film that I don't think a whole ton of people have heard of or seen, and that's a crime. Parasite from Bong Joon-ho is incredible. From everything, its acting, its narrative, symbolism, metaphors, and down to its acting, it is all so beautifully done and well crafted, masterfully crafted even. It's just a joy. It's a movie that's hard to talk about without spoiling anything, but in essence, it's a movie that examines the difference in classes. There is a very wealthy class of people, the upper echelon, and they're needing help, and eventually they get help from the lower class. And then the two worlds collide, and you're seeing a lot of different things from each side here, ultimately leading to a fantastic conclusion and something that I think viewers would think about well after the movie's concluded. It's a movie you could see three times and still pick up on different things. Again, the movie is a foreign film, so it's subtitled in English, and I feel like that's much better because if it was dubbed, I feel it'd lose an element of what makes it so special. If you know, if fucking Four Kids used one of its four voice actors to voice act this, I think it would lose something very important to its core. And I know a lot of people probably don't like reading subtitles, but it's worth reading for this movie to get this experience. This movie has a very impressive narrative it wants to tell you, and it's not only a powerful message, but it's a really fun one too. There's a lot of humor and comedy in this movie that lands very well. It's a movie that you'll laugh with and then also feel some very real things about. It's a really great movie and unlike any other movie I saw this year. So Parasite comfortably takes the number one spot, earning the Moistie for the best movie of 2019. And that's about it, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to this year's Moisties. That's all. See ya.